We are inching closer to Monday's federal election. It's one that Prime Minister Justin Trudeau hopes will result in a majority of Parliament's 338 seats going to his Liberal Party. Brock Associate Professor of Political Science Liviana Tasuti joins The Source. Dr. Tasuti, does Trudeau's incumbency as Prime Minister help him or make him an easy target for this election?
Well, normally incumbency is an advantage because it impels the opposition to explain why they could do a better job managing government. However, this is a really unusual election and not one that, if you believe the polls, the majority of Canadians wanted. So the fact that Mr. Trudeau called an election when one wasn't technically necessary could end up backfiring on him.
You've recently studied some provincial elections in three different provinces in Canada. In all of those cases, a minority government was returned as a majority government, but that's not necessarily a trend that you think might happen here in this national election?
Well, that's right. In fact, there was an exception. Nova Scotia actually saw a change of power in government. So in general, minority governments were returned with majorities. I still think that the likelihood is that the Liberals will be turned with a minority, but not the majority they were seeking.
Trudeau has really become a target in this election. And it's clear whether we're talking about the local debates we've had with our local candidates here on your TV or the national debates that the other candidates seem to gang up on him.
Absolutely. His government has been in power for 6 years, and it's his responsibility to explain why Canadians should trust another Trudeau mandate and to explain where his government fell short, and also to defend his record and to tell Canadians what the government did right in terms of advancing its agenda, but also managing the pandemic. So he is the target, and you saw that in last week's debate, of course, in which he really acted as a pincushion for the attacks of the different opposition parties on his record.
In certain ridings as well, they tend to be almost a bellwether as to what happens nationally, St. Catharines being one of those ridings. Do you think that will hold true in this case?
I think so. I think St. Catharines and to a slightly lesser extent Niagara Falls are bellwether ridings, pretty good ones for predicting how the country will go. So I'll be watching closely to see what happens there. Both ridings are competitive, and we'll see what happens.
Dr. Tasuti, what is your take on the violence in some of the protests that have happened along the campaign trail?
Well, it's disturbing, firstly, that you have the importation of the type of behavior we saw at Trump rallies in the U.S. presidential election inserted into Canadian politics. Certainly having raucous elections isn't new in Canadian political history, but this, I think, takes it to a different level. It's disturbing. And I also think that perhaps the people who are turning out to these rallies, the anti-vaxxers, are from a spectrum, a political spectrum that includes people who don't traditionally vote or vote for very small parties. So in a sense, it's bringing in people who've been disaffected by politics, but I think most Canadians would not approve of the type of the behavior, the obscenities and the violence that we're seeing, and would wish that that new people being brought into politics would adopt a different type of behavior.
Do you think that this is a trend that we will see continuing in future elections?
I think so. I think this is the future. Look at the rise in the fortunes of the People's Party of Canada in the polls. They have done extremely well in the polls. It may not translate into seats, but almost 7% are indicating an intention to vote for the PPC. So it shows there is a significant untapped part of the Canadian electorate that the other mainstream parties haven't reached that this party is able to reach. So that is something to watch for in the future.
Dr. Tasuti, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you for inviting me, Mike.